Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, in the last lecture we have studied about that is what is organic compounds and what are the applications of the organic compounds that we see in industrial applications or in our day-to-day life. But in that case, what we have got to know that these are the organic compounds that has a wide range of applications. Along with that, they have a special characteristic and general characteristic. So what are those general characteristics? Let us talk about that also. So these are the few general characteristics that I am going to talk about, and that is very essential for us to understand because of the thing that we are going to study a very deep detail about the organic chemistry. So talking about the first one, that is composition. So organic compounds are been known to because of it consists of the carbon atoms, and it is not necessary that only the carbon atom would be only bonded with the hydrogen so as to form a hydrocarbon. But yes, there are also the derivatives of that hydrocarbons, or yes, there are also some compounds that has basically carbon along with that of hydrogen, with that of oxygen, phosphorus, sulfur, etc. For example, there are various of the chemicals that is what we have studied in the industrial application also, like in polythene that we make as PVC, and like that of the antibiotic aspirin. So in that case, basically this consists of the carbon along with that of hydrogen and along with that of the other elements like that of the oxygen, sulfur, etc. Even the DNA that we have, and that DNA is composed of basically the carbon, hydrogen, phosphorus also has been there, and that is the reason that they are called to be organic compounds. So there are certain organic compounds that are known because of carbon and because of the other elements also. Talking about the next one, that is the another characteristic, that is type of linkage. So carbon has the capacity when it comes to the organic compounds, and that what we are dealing with the carbon, and carbon has the capacity to not only form one bond, but they can form multiple bonds. That is, they can form carbon-carbon single bond, carbon-carbon double bond, carbon-carbon triple bond, and not only with the carbon atom, but they could form the linkage, or they could form the bond with the other elements like of oxygen, nitrogen also. And somewhere the bond would be weak, or somewhere the bond would be strong, and it depends on that. So therefore, there are various types of the linkage that is been formed by the carbon atoms or being formed by the organic compounds. And talking about the next one, that is catenation. So what is actually catenation? Catenation is nothing but a property of a compound that so as to form a long chain, a branch chain, or either a cyclic chain compounds. So therefore, this property are basically showcased by the carbon atoms, or basically are showcased by the organic compounds, and that is what the catenation is, the special characteristic or a kind of general characteristic that has been shown by that is the organic compounds. And now talking about the next one. That is isomerism. So before understanding that what is actually isomerism, we should know that what is actually isomers. So isomers are basically those compounds which have the same molecular formula but different structural formula. So it will also depend on the different functional group also. And in this case, those compounds which shows this kind of property and which possesses this kind of isomerism property are basically, they will have the straight chain, they will have a branch chain. So depending on the structure, that would change, and yes, depending on the functional group also. And but the total number of the carbon atom, or we could say the total number of the atoms that would be present for a particular compound, it would be the same to that of the isomer of which we have considered. So now that is nothing known as basically isomerism. So this is the property that has been usually showcased by the organic compounds. Talking about the next one, that is polymerization. So what is actually polymerization? Polymerization is nothing but the conversion of a small molecules, that is we call it as monomer, to a larger molecule. And that larger molecule will have a larger atomic that is larger molecular mass, and obviously the size of that would be more also. So that is the thing, that this kind of process where a monomer is been converted into a polymer, and that kind of process is basically known as polymerization. And this is usually showcased in that is organic compounds, and that's the reason that we could see polyethene. Polyethene is somewhere a polymer of ethene, and ethene is a very small molecule, but when it comes to the polymer of ethene, that is polyethene, it is a very large molecule consisting of obviously the larger molecular mass. So this kind of property is been showcased by that is organic compounds, and that makes a characteristic of it. And talking about solubility. because organic compounds are those compounds which consist of basically carbon and hydrogen, and basically usually they form in non-polar compounds. And non-polar compounds are basically usually soluble in non-polar solvents. So that's the reason that these are not that much soluble in that of water, but yes, they are soluble in other organic solvents, and that is the solubility of the organic compound that we could see. Even suppose if I talk about kerosene. Kerosene or kind of fats or oils. These are certain compounds that are not soluble in water because they are basically organic also. And that's the reason that the solubility would change depending on which organic compound that we are talking about or that we are concerned about. So talking about the next one, that is melting point and boiling point. Yes, these are the characteristics that we could see because of we know that organic compounds are such compounds which are basically can form a single bond, long chain, they could form a branch chain. So that makes it to have different kind of melting point and boiling point. And usually they have very low melting point and boiling point. And that's the reason we could see some of the chemicals like ethene or propane. So this all methane, this all are basically the those compounds which have a low melting point and boiling point, and hence there are some kind of organic compounds also that has larger or higher, that is melting point and boiling point, depending on the number of chain that it has or what is the catenation property in that case. So it will depend on that. So that is what we have got to know. And talking about the next one, that is odor. Odor is nothing but smell. So some of the chemicals have a very sweet and pleasant smell. So that is the characteristic that we could identify, know that this compound would be a particular compound. For example, that is like acetone. Acetone is what it has a basically, or we could say that a sweet smell has been present over there. So we could identify that this compound would be acetophenol. So a special kind of a characteristic smell has been present for a particular organic compound, not for everyone, but in that case, this also is a characteristic of the organic compounds from which we could detect. And talking about the next one, that is combustibility. Combustibility is nothing but a property that an organic compound can be turned into a reaction that would give evolution of heat in presence of oxygen. So that is basically known as combustion reaction. So most of the organic compounds undergo combustibility, or most of the organic compounds show combustion reaction by the evolution of heat or by evolution of thermal energy. So these are the properties that are being showcased by organic compounds also. And talking about the next one, that is functional group. This functional group plays a very important role in differentiating the organic compounds. For example, if I would say that the molecular formula of an alcohol and molecular formula of an ether, the both are the same, but the only thing that divides them and in terms of the chemical reactivity or in terms of the physical property is the functional group. Yes, one has an hydroxyl group, that is an alcoholic group, while one has an oxygen atom that has been attached to two alkyl groups, making that to be called as an ether. So therefore they have a characteristic functional group, and because of which the reactivity or the physical property is also being dependent on. So therefore they have something related to functional group, and that is a characteristic of an organic compound. And talking about the last one, that is homologous series. So what is actually homologous series? Homologous series is a series of the those compounds which are differing, and they are also present in a series and in a very sequence manner, so as they could differ in the number of carbon atom as one and number of hydrogen atom as two. So therefore CH2 would be the difference between the two. For example, when I'm talking about methane and when I'm talking about ethane and propane. So suppose if these three are the compounds that we have, and if we compare these three, we could find that there is a difference between the two sequence, that is methane and ethane, with the difference of CH2. So that is basically a homologous series. So therefore, this homologous series are being shown by the organic compounds, and we know that the organic compounds are made up of carbon, and the carbon has the capacity to bond with hydrogen, oxygen, and to bond with carbon also. So that is the catenation property that it has, and that is the reason that a homologous series is the one that we could study very easily and that we could predict. So this all properties are dependent on each other somewhere, they are dependent on each other, and that is what we are studying, that what are the general characteristics of organic compounds. So these are the general characteristics of organic compounds that we have got to know. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly, and you will share this video with the friends. So don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.